right. We're going to take some questions, you said, before you do his other tracks. Anybody want to ask any questions? Yes, you know.
Can you make audio libraries by yourself?
I can, but I don't know.
The first one, I put my thesis. So, one of my favorites, the last song up in here, well, the last song I played on the last two.
Is that flame gear? Flame gear? Flame gear?
Flame gear? Yeah, that's a special.
You go to heaven, you got my brother in the
world. If I can go to
heaven?
Yeah, this is the me personally, you know, this is just a side comment, man. You really don't need to get your success. Regardless of how many doors or not in doors, I know my sense of dream room. So honestly, like, my people are always looking for doors. Me personally, I don't know why people look for doors because at the end of the day, you gotta work for a shit. So you trying to get it free, it's not your own job. And at the end of the day, you have to work for it to be free, and it's still worth it. Me personally, as of right now, I'm getting used to it. But one thing that you have to always understand with every year or any year is be adaptive. A lot of people don't know how to adapt. There are, especially for me, that is playing for take advantage, you know, that is a chance to have a food program. So I've been playing with them for a year now, and one thing that I always have to adapt to is regardless of something. Background or not, I don't know what I'm getting. You know, everything is really like limbo, per se. So it's like, you could walk in, even if it's a church, you always have to be adaptive to what's going on, because I've seen a lot of people who try to like, completely change setups just because they want to get away. So me personally, I don't think it makes it easier when you're trying to be more adaptive to any situation, because then they'll call you for anything. It's like, okay, these professors, you know, work through anything, no matter how tough the situation is, that's just my best, be adaptive. So I really did those first two tracks and just get warmed up. It's kind of good for you to get. So, the next two tracks are just like your tracks. So, that's the best thing for a channel. But when you're just
What did winning the drum off do for you? Do for your career?
Just what did you see the biggest change?
The biggest change? Alright, I'll be transparent. Because it's social media. I went to $5,000. That changed my entire life because I did not know what to do. The first thing that I did was get everything. I got everything that I needed from drums to passports, anything that I would need as a musician, completely now, so I wouldn't have to worry about it later. So, with the drum off of stuff, I got a whole bunch of drum sets, got endorsement deals, and a whole bunch of other prizes, but to get you more specific to your question, it definitely helped me seriously to know specifically
who is for me and who's not for me, and it really helped me to decipher real friendships and real relationships with people, because I've watched so many people that I've heard or may have even seen that may not even like me, and just flat out was like, oh, that's my brother. I'm just like, I took him very seriously, like extremely seriously, and it's also really helped me be a professional in the aspect of being respectful to whoever or whatever situation. It taught me how to really stand by my words firmly, because even before I wanted to jump off, I always told myself that I would never change, regardless of whatever fame or whatever anybody would consider to be. Like, I always made sure that I told myself that I would never be different from some money or a TV show or a stage. And that's why, like, I was actually going to come here regardless. I was going to play. You know, they just called me. They called me last night. I was like, yeah, you're going to play. So I'm like, okay, sure.
I sure did.
You can call me Justice, but anyways.
I told him to call.
I was coming anyway.
I know, I called him. I texted him.
It taught me a lot. I could go so many deeper into it, but really it just taught me how to be a better man for myself, spiritually, mentally, environmentally, with people, and stuff like that. Because I deal with a lot of people that I don't know, and then I deal with a lot of people that I do know. So it's just a cool bunch of stuff. That's just interesting.
How do you prepare for your shows? For your shows?
My shows?
Yeah.
Okay. Not gonna lie, y'all. My process is weird. So, are you talking about music or are you talking about like actual shows?
Yeah, actually, yeah, we gotta perform. When I perform,
oh,
we gotta
okay.
Play. Yeah.
So, show us. All right, so this question is how do I prepare for shows? First off, I pray. Because regardless of where I am, I realize that I've dealt with a lot of situations where I thought that I would be a good man doing certain things or playing for secular artists. But one thing that I realized was even Jesus didn't hang with all Christians. You know, he stepped out sometimes, but what made a difference was being a light in the darkness. And that's something that I've always tried to stand for regardless of where I am. And that's why I stand to the point where I told myself way in, I don't want to change regardless of where I am. So I pray first and foremost. It's not easy. I'm not gonna lie. It's not easy. It's not. But I pray. I take what I see, and I really try to make a difference out of it, whether it's good or bad. Yeah. Any other questions? Cool. Oh, okay. So, so yeah, this is
the real.
I like your phone.
This is the real me that most people don't get to see on a daily basis. So this song was a song that I recorded for my youth church by a friend of mine named Javante Howard. So if you want to look for the original, it's on SoundCloud.
Amen.
I get it.